some truth to it, but not quite. I would like to finish on a positive note. Well, we saw some examples right here in the previous presentation that yes, mobility research was applied to some specific problems and used by the Israeli army. And I'm sure you can also think about several other examples. One that I can think quickly about is a central inflation control device on the US Army trucks, where if you got into a soft soil, you lower the pressure, increase the ground contact area, move on. Now you get on the highway, where low pressure would be, of course, not a disadvantage, then you inflate it again. So there are some positive results. Our work, it was not just an ivory tower exercise, lapunar exercise. My best example for useful application is, of course, the NATO reference mobility model. At least until I was working at TACOM, it was very extensively used in the vehicle procurement process, where different bids concept that the different companies put in when there was a demand for, let's say, a new truck or some new vehicle. And it was evaluated, these bids were evaluated from many viewpoints, but one was mobility. And for that quantitative evaluation, the NATO reference mobility model was used. Well, I mentioned NATO reference mobility model. It was first called the Army mobility model, but NATO accepted it. And used it also, 5 or 6 NATO countries. So, again, I would like to remind you that this NATO reference mobility model was a realization of Becker's original goal that he outlined at the first conference in a kind of a visionary way. And that concludes what I have conjured up from my memory. And if you have any questions, I'm sure I probably can't answer them, but anyway, let's try. I can tell you many more stories. Some of them will be gossip, so.
Thank you, Professor Janosi. Now, it was a very interesting and informative presentation about the history of ISTVS. We enjoyed it very much. Thank you, Ariel. Now, we have break until 3 o'clock, when the second part of the anniversary session will be.